In this demonstration, we will discuss working with oXygen to edit files stored on a SharePoint repository. oXygen has extended the existing SharePoint support by improving the browsing capabilities and allowing access to more information about the stored documents. To highlight some of the features of the SharePoint support, we'll connect to a SharePoint repository and perform a series of common tasks. We'll create a new document, and then search for an existing one using the new filtering capabilities. Let's begin by connecting to a SharePoint repository using the SharePoint browser. To display this view, go to Window, Show View, SharePoint Browser. By default, the view is displayed below the editing area. We will now configure a new SharePoint connection. A dialog is presented allowing you to specify the connection details, such as the server URL, the domain, the username, and the password. Next, click OK to save the new connection. oXygen automatically connects to the SharePoint repository. Note that if you have already defined SharePoint connections, they will appear in the site drop-down list located at the top of the view. The browser offers a specialized layout for navigating a SharePoint site, with its structure being presented in the left side in a tree-like fashion, providing an overview of its hierarchy. On the first level, you will find the subsites of the main site, as well as the available libraries, which are organized in folders. The context menu of a folder allows you to delete or rename it, and also to create new subfolders and documents. The New Document action provides quick access to all document templates available in oXygen. So, let's create a new data topic. We'll choose the data topic template and name our file features.data. The newly created topic is now added in the right side of the browser, which presents the content of the folder currently selected in the left side tree. This also displays the properties of the documents and folders. Each property is represented as a column. The set of properties along with the set of resources available in the table depends on the library's currently selected view. The current view of a library is displayed between brackets. You can change the view using the context menu. By selecting another view, the contents of the current library may change depending upon how the view is configured. In our case, the Data Resources view is configured so that only the data documents are displayed, filtering out other types of resources stored in the Documents library. Note that the Rename and Delete actions are available in the Table's context menu, both for documents and folders. You may also perform tasks like Checkout, Check-in, and Discard Checkout on one or more documents at the same time. You can also filter and sort the displayed items. For example, let's sort the documents according to their title. Next, we'll see how we can filter a column. You can apply multiple filters at the same time. You can choose from available filters or input an additional custom search value. To display the filters for a column, click the filter widget located on its header. Let's suppose that we want to view the properties for a document that we have previously edited. First, we'll filter the modified by column and select the filter corresponding to this username. We now see that the table has fewer items, displaying only the documents that were last modified by this user. However, there are still too many documents displayed. Let's now add a filter in the title column. We can use the filter that accepts text input in order to search for our document. We'll start typing the title of a document. The table is once again filtered, now displaying fewer documents. We can also view the current version of the document along with other properties such as the date and time when it was last modified. Note that a column can be filtered or sorted only if it was configured this way on the server side. In our case, the name column cannot be filtered, whereas the title column can be filtered. So, we found the appropriate file. Since we want to edit the document, we'll perform a checkout action by right-clicking the resource and selecting the checkout action. Double-click on the document to open it. The document is now open in the editor area. Note that there is an alternative method to connect to a SharePoint repository by using the Open URL dialog. You will need to input the connection details. And click Connect. Notice that the dialog presents the same structure as the SharePoint browser and all of its functionality is available. This concludes our demonstration. As always, thank you for watching.